Thank you very much. I really like all these games, and a big applause to all the participants of this game jam. And hopefully this game jam helps that more and more game jam are happening here in Moscow, because I think it's a very good idea to create a community around the medium, about an art form, what is very, very important, I guess, nowadays. So, now my presentation. I'm Thorsten Wiedemann, founder, this is my Twitter account. And I'm doing festivals with Amaze. So, I have a festival in Berlin, what is in April. It's about independent games, and the international independent game scene comes to Berlin once a year and try to win an award. So we have four awards. One is the most amazing game, the overall best game. Then we have the Human Machine Award, what is the local multiplayer award, where two people or more people playing together, I'm going to show later some examples, and connected to a machine. But the machine must be not visible, so it could be as well somewhere and you have something in your hand, and you're not in front of a screen or you're away from the keyboard. And the third award is the What the Fuck Award, what is the award for glitch games, punk games, art games, all the games you normally don't know when you're not inside the community. So this festival helps to make all these games visible, and especially all the independent game creations. And we have as well an audience award, and for next year, because virtual reality is a big buzz right now, probably most of the people know about the Oculus Rift or Sony Morpheus. Everything has to be now in 3D, and we have to wear glasses, and so we need as well an award for this, because a lot of game developers trying new stuff and very, very experimental and cool stuff as well. And then right after this workshop, I go to Berlin, and then I fly to Johannesburg, because the festival, the next Amaze Festival, is in Johannesburg from the 10th to the 13th of September. It's kind of a copy-paste festival just in Africa, and I bring some European game developers and media artists to Johannesburg to meet this community, to exchange, to learn more, to make connections, to come over to Europe to show their games, and so on. I mean, festivals are about meeting people, right? To creating a kind of a moment where everybody comes together and show their game and having fun together. And of course we have talks, lectures, and workshops, and game jams, and a lot of games to play. So this is in Berlin at Urban Spree, it's in Friedrichshain, and so this is the place where it's going to happen. This year we had around 4,000 people there, we had 500 professionals there, and then the general public who like to play all the games and play all the installations. So I like punk rock, so this is something what is essential, especially for the DIY world. So be rough, to just try out, make something happen, you know, you just have an idea and you do it. This is very important, you just do it. And this is a kind of a fan video somebody did with wine.
I'm
Yeah, this is the award. This is the award for the most amazing game.
So it's out of silly. He did it actually because everybody was looking in his window, what he's doing. He wants to have his privacy.
Yeah, thanks a lot. And hopefully this inspires you to make games and playful stuff, and hopefully I also have the chance to come back and do maybe a small festival or something like that about this. I see a lot of people already here. Everybody loves playing, right? So, if you have any questions, please let me know. Okay, thanks a lot. Oh, you have questions. Many questions. Okay, back to the questions.
Sorry, I will speak English. At first, a video when you show your festival, it was like a familiar game as drugs, sex and rock and roll. And then it's like underground, and when you will, for example, you will be at metro, in Moscow metro or in Berlin, you will see that all people are playing casual games. Mm-hmm. So, and it's like they kill a time. And what do you think about these games? Maybe this our life, like underground metro, all life, and you steal your games, have all of these underground people kill the time. So, mm-hmm. How do you think about this?
What's the question actually now?
About game. Why in your festival, in your video, I don't see children's.
Because most of them are in nighttime. So I mean, we have a lot. We are partying a lot, and we love music, and it's not about drugs and sex and rock and roll. It's really about video games. It's a But it has, of course, this kind of culture to be a little bit more rock and roll. So and during the daytime, because the exhibition is open during the day, kids are coming in, families are coming in, playing the games. Because we show no games with nudity or something like that, and nothing what is really brutal. We show games what are kind of essentially very, very value for the population. I mean, how can I answer your question? You don't like it?
I'm really...
But again, please. No. I just want to answer you the question. I don't understand the point with the metro or not.
Actually, these games, what you've shown and what, for example, workshop games, they are all casual. And these casual games, for me, for example, for you, I think for young men, they are really killing the time. So they
are they killing time?
Yes, they don't make me creative. As the first time you
I mean, you can do those games, yeah?
For game, you think about painting like an artist. So for, and as a musical programmer, I want to make life more creative. And I need a novelty. I need a stuff that make art. But you, how to say, you just, how to say,
no, I can take this thing now.
No.
Хорошо. Я говорю о том, что, в общем-то, вот эта культура игр казуальных, она, по сути, подменяет настоящую потребность в настоящих играх с хорошей, в общем-то, графикой, красотой, в которой нуждаются, в общем-то, дети. Не люди, которые уже работают, в общем-то, ну, как рабы в некотором смысле, они озабочены большими проблемами, и они уже не могут настоящего не любить. Не ходить в театр куда-то. И они вынуждены, в общем-то, подменять некоторые истинные ценности искусства, в общем-то, ради чего это делается, на какие-то некоторые суррогаты, фактически это имитаторы. Имитаторы в полном понимании смысла. И в данном случае текст, и когда вы показали ну, о том, что якобы imagination is going away, ну, как бы воображение уходит, и текст вдруг сможет вернуть, это, наоборот, кажется, в сферу медиа просто... Ну, до конца просто утопит любое воображение.
I mean, this is the point. I mean, you have to understand the medium, because it's not about. I mean, it's about interaction, because the interaction is also telling stories. You know, it's not about that the game has to have a story or the. It's because it's a new kind of art form. Of course, you can. And this is what I say, and I compare it that. It's like art, like a painter did, you know? I mean, he also doing something what he likes to do. It's his passion to put paint on a canvas. And it's great if you like it. Most people don't like it. Other people really like it. I don't know, some people paying millions for it. And I think games is something like that. It's just starting that people really using this medium as an art form. I mean, of course, there are genre games, shooter games, there are whatever, party games. But as well, like this Lea Schönfelder, it's a kind of an experience in a different art, in a different way. Of course, you also can read a book about feminism. But I mean, it's maybe nicer to play a game about feminism. I don't know. So I mean, it's something what you have to choose. If you like more books, then read books. If you like more film, then look film. I mean, is it maybe it's a waste of time as well, watching a film? Or going to a gallery and see a bad show, you know? It's the same thing, I guess. I mean, it's, yeah.
Нет, не работает. В подземке, да, люди часто можно видеть. Каждый уткнулся свой iPhone.
Game about anything, you know? I mean, it's really kind of... and you saw it in the game jam, so we had this idea of making a game that game doesn't work. So, and there are kind of games what you can play around this topic, and it's more this kind of game jam idea I really like, because it's really bringing people together and sharing the same passion. And I did one game. It was a three button game, so where it was for the global game jam, where you see in front of a snake, you can just move the snake through the sand. By typing the fingers in the same rhythm. When you keep in the same rhythm all the time, then the snake moves. When you're out of the rhythm, the snake falls back. And the goal was to bite yourself into the tie, to the end of your snake. I mean, it's never published. I don't want to publish a game right now. And I don't have time to make games. Of course, you really have all the time. You have ideas. Yeah, we can do this and this and that. But you need a team, and I can't code. I'm not good in art, music, also not very well. So I think I skip this. Yeah, I'm doing this festival. Yeah. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Это уже третий конец, когда он говорит thank you.